Kan, shalom, all praise to Yahweh, Bashem, Yahshai, Bashem, Kakadash. Double honors to the apostles and elders of great millstone. And salutations to the hopeful electors pushing this truth in sincerity. I want to focus on the abortion topic. This is one of the things that is actually strongly being promoted by the oppressor. To abort life. That is what the oppressor is pushing upon our people, man. You know, so I came across this article. I saw myself as a mass murderer. Former abortion provider shares a story. You know, so this this former abortion provider, she actually came to her senses, and she just acknowledged that the thing that she was doing was just totally off, man. You know, you just and you gotta question yourself, like, what kind of spirit does a person have to be when you wanna execute something like this, man? You know, you're dealing with mass of people continually stepping into your office, and you are the appointed person to execute something like this. That's truly not something that everybody can do, man. You know, it really requires a certain spirit. So what I want to do is I want to play this video. And in this video, are you for real? In this video, life, wow, yeah, life in 4 minutes. And this video is actually going to explain the whole process of the impregnation, the fertilization, and the growing of a child inside of a woman, man. You know, and when you just see this whole process, you understand, like, you should not abort this life, man. You should not. So I just want to play this video, and I want to grab a couple of scriptures. I'll quickly read through the article, and Yara Tazal, it will be edifying. You know, we're going to filter all these things through the scriptures, because abortion is not allowed according to the Most High, man. You know, and this whole vibration of pushing it to the earth and teaching the people that it's acceptable, it really needs to stop, because it's a vibration, a way of being that is warring against the Most High, man. You know, so let me see which one I'm going to use, because I don't want no community guidelines strikes. You know how ESO be rolling right now. So I think this one.
Thank you.
So that is an animation of life, so to say. 9 months. Boom. I want to grab a couple of scriptures first, man. This is the first scripture that I want to get. This is the book of Psalms. The book of Psalms, chapter 104. And abortion is an important topic, man. And a lot of our sisters, man, you know, the daughters of Zion, which are the so-called dark brown-skinned women, the Latinas and the Native Indians, they really need to take heed onto this message, man. You know, because the oppressor is truly misleading and deceiving our people into committing abortion, man. It's unacceptable with the Most High, man. So this is the book of Psalms, chapter 104, verse 29. Thou hidest thy face, they are troubled. Thou takest away their breath, they die, and return to the dust. You see, so it's the Heavenly Father that can take away the life of the people on this earth, man. You know, and they return to dust because we are all from the dust. We all go back to Adam. Verse 30. Thou sendest forth thy spirit, they are created, and thou renewest the face of the earth. Yeah, because when the Heavenly Father sends the spirit, that is when life begins. So when you saw the child being placed inside of that woman and developing and growing, that was already the moment when life was already taking place inside of the woman, man. You know, because the man carries the seed, and the seed is swimming, which is life by itself. And the life, the living seed, is entering into the egg, and that is the process of the fertilization. And that is when that seed, which was inside of the man who carries the boys and the girls, starts growing inside of a woman. So it means that the man gives life. He puts life inside of a woman, and the woman bears life. The woman is the one who's pushing the life outside of her. The life which came from the husband, from the man. This is the book of Exodus, chapter 20, verse 13. Thou shalt not kill. Very clear law which is written in the Bible. You will not kill. Meaning, when that child is growing, no matter what kind of size you think the child is, or how you want to perceive it, well, it's not that big enough, so it's not living, it's no life, it's living, it's life. So when you decide to abort that life, you are committing murder. You are committing murder in the eyes of the Most High. You see? Because when is this child being born? How did that life started for that child? How did that whole process came to pass of that seed ending inside of the womb, the egg swimming to the seed swimming to the egg? As mentioned in Wisdom of Solomon, chapter 7, verse 2. And in my mother's womb was fashioned to be flesh in the time of 10 months, being compacted in blood of the seed of men, the seed of men, and the pleasure that came with sleep, intercourse. So the moment when there was intercourse, the woman was fertile, the man placed the seed inside of the woman, the fertilization, and the child started to grow inside of the woman. That is how it went. You see? And then, this whole process, which you saw over there in the video, you know, the child being a seed, and that seed growing and developing, hands, nails, bones. This is all documented in the Bible, man. This is the book of Ecclesiastes 11, verse 5. As thou knowest not what is the way of the spirit, nor how bones do grow in the womb of her that is with child, even so thou knowest not the works of the Most High who make it all. So you will not fully understand all the things of the Most High. This is life. This is the beauty, man. A child is a blessing. If someone is not capable of taking care of the child, give the child to someone who is capable of raising the child. But don't terminate the life of the child because you doubt, because you might say, the husband, the father figure stepped out of my life. I don't want to deal with it by myself, so I'm going to terminate his life. You have certain women, females, upon this earth who just don't want the child, who would lie to their husband that they had a miscarriage, and then they commit abortion. It's almost too hard to believe that you have females like that. But the scripture speaks about the wickedness of a woman. You have females upon this earth who are capable of doing such things, my man. Who are capable of doing such things. This is Sirach 25 verse 19. All wickedness is but little to the wickedness of a woman. Let the portion of a sinner fall upon her. If you will look upon the wickedness that has been done upon this earth by the wicked, wicked-minded men, rulers, psychopaths, evil scientists, and you look upon the wickedness of a woman is capable of using a child against her husband because she is not, she has strife or argue with her husband, and she will use her child, saying, "You are never going to see my child. You are not going to see your baby anymore." This is the wickedness of a woman. The wickedness of a woman is saying that she has a miscarriage and hopes that you believe it so that she can commit an abortion. Those are examples of the wickedness of a woman. And no, we're not generalizing about all the women upon this earth. I'm speaking about the wicked ones, man. Because a virtuous woman, a morally excellent woman, which goes according to the heart of the Most High, wouldn't think about these things, man. A virtuous woman would not be thinking about such wicked things, man. You know? Only a wicked woman would do something like that, man. You see? So the scripture speaks, makes me also think about in the book of 2 Maccabees. You had this situation with the sons, and I believe it was and with the mother, and her mother, her sons were actually slayed in front of her by Antiochus, man, because they wouldn't bow down unto the ways of the ruler. Meaning, we're speaking here about some courageous, powerful faith, man. Standing stiffly for the Most High, even unto death, man, martyrdom, you know. And then think about this, man, how strong of a spirit, how strong and how close the Most High must have been unto this woman, man. When you might see your sons being slaughtered, brutalized, tortured to death on the most horrific ways, man, and you're still standing and still proclaiming the love and the faithfulness, your loyalty towards the Most High, man. You know, this is 2 Maccabees chapter 7, verse 22. I cannot tell how you came into my womb, for I neither gave you breath nor life. Neither was it I that formed the members of every one of you. You see, this is all by the works of the Most High, man. This is what the Most High did, man. You know, I will jump to... I actually just want to grab the key points of this... this thing. Verse 27. But she bowing herself towards him, laughing to the cruel tyrant to scorn, spake in a country language on this matter. O my son, have pity upon me that bare thee 9 months in my womb, and gave thee such 3 years and nourished thee, and brought thee up unto this age and endured the troubles of education. Yeah, because she was actually reaching out and speaking towards her son. You know, because the evil tormentor was busy with some madness, man. You can just take your time to read 2 Maccabees chapter 7 till and down. It's not very difficult to understand. It's more storytelling concerning history. it's easy to understand. This is a beautiful example of strong faith in the Most High and being faithful unto death, man. You know, no fear. So going on, I'll jump to the book of Jeremiah. The book of Jeremiah, chapter 31, verse 22. How long wilt thou go about, O thou backsliding daughter? For the Lord hath created a new thing in the earth. A woman shall compass a man. And that is what you see right now on this earth, man. A woman is compassing a man. And guess what? The woman can decide by saying things. The child grew up in my body, 9 months inside of me. I decide what happens with the child, whether the child lives or whether the child dies. You see, this is what happens right now upon this earth, man. The man has no saying in anything. Yeah, well, he can say, like, you should keep the child, don't abort. But in the end, it's like the woman just does what she wants to do, man. So let me just quickly read to this, man. After performing around 1,000 abortions, Dr. Katie Altman came to a disturbing realization. She had legally killed more people than the serial killer Ted Bundy, and that's a fact. I didn't see the fetus as any different from the chicken embryos that I dissected in college, Altman said in an interview on the Van Maden show. She was strongly pro-abortion, according to the Daily Signal, and believed that it was a woman's right to abort a child, to murder a child, to decide if you terminate that child's life. You decide that. Understand that they don't have the right to decide that, man. I felt that I was a woman's advocate and I was helping women. So I felt I was doing everything right, she said. And I love taking care of women. However, while working at a neonatal intensive care unit, she began to doubt the ethics of abortions. She was saving babies in the NICU that were the same age as the one she was also aborting. Her breaking point came shortly after she gave birth. I moonlighted doing abortions at a clinic and continued to do even when I was pregnant. How could you? How can you? It's just unbelievable, man. How can you be pregnant? How can you be pregnant and commit abortions on other women? Taking life away from them while life is growing inside of you, man. That's the hypocritical shit you could do, man. And I saw no incongruity with that. She said, my baby was wanted, there was not. And that was the difference. My delivery. However, when I came back to the work in the clinic, something had changed in my mind. Because I felt a little different all of a sudden. And I was confronted with 3 patients that basically changed my life. One patient was using abortion as birth control, another admitted to wanting to kill it, referring to her baby, and the third cried during the entire procedure. The fact that they were unwanted was no longer enough justification for me to kill them, Altman said. The sad thing is that I still referred for abortion. I still believed abortion was a woman's right. I just sort of thought it was the lesser of two evils, and I took God a long time to completely change my mind. She decided to never perform another abortion again, but did not speak out on the practice. It was until she read an article comparing abortion to the Holocaust that Altman joined the pro-life movement. When I became a doctor, I couldn't understand how the German doctors could do what they did until I read that article, she said. They could do it just like I could kill babies, because we didn't consider them human. She said, this was the first time that I saw myself as a mass murderer. I thought, oh my gosh, I've killed a lot of people, a lot of more people than Ted Bundy, but it wasn't illegal, she said, and that was when I became pro-life. Since a conversation, she testified pro-Congress on the Heartbeat Protection Act, which forbids abortion after 6 weeks of gestation when a baby's heart can be detected. Our society has been subjected to extreme propaganda, she said in a testimony, We have sanitized our language to make abortion more palatable. I don't believe a woman can remain unscathed after killing a child. And that is what it is, man. Because the fact that stays is that when a woman bears a child grows inside of a woman, there's a bonding process taking place, man. You know? And when you decide, even when the child is already there, the moment when the spirit is inside of the woman, that is already a bonding process. So when you decide to abort the child, you're aborting a piece of yourself, man. Literally. So what do you think? That it will not have an effect on you? Most definitely it will. You know? So let me get this scripture, man. Because they said it's their body. They can decide. That is how they want to react. It's their body. This is 1 Corinthians 6, verse 19. What? Know you not that your body is the temple of the Most High, the Holy Spirit, which is in you, which ye have of the Most High, and ye are not your own? That shows you that this scripture is explaining that you are not of your own. It's not your body. Your body belongs unto the Most High. The life that is inside of you belongs unto the Most High. And the first law said it already in Exodus 20 verse 13, thou shalt not kill. You see? So it's not up to you to decide whether you want to terminate. That is not up to them. But a lot of them really think that they have the right to do those things, man. Because this system, it's this system that is giving them this power, this liberty, the space to do these things, man. You see? It's the horribleness, the terribleness of the wicked. This is the book of Sirach 26, verse 10. If thy daughter be shameless, keep her in straitly, lest she abuse herself to overmuch liberty. And that is what's happening right now with these females, man. They receive too much liberty, they receive too much power, which is actually completely out of orders, out of line, which is causing them to think that it's acceptable that I can commit this horrible act, man. Straight up murder, man. You know? And Heavenly Father is not down with it, man. This is the book of Exodus 23, verse 26. There shall nothing cast their young, nor be barren in thy land. The number of thy days I will fulfill. And I will go into the word cast. There shall nothing cast their young.
Strong's 8:79:21. Shachol.
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 Shachol. Speaking about miscarried, bereave, make childless, miscarry, is speaking about abort. Here, to cause barrenness, show barrenness, or abort. You see? So you're not supposed to do that, man. You're not supposed to do that. And what is this society, this system teaching our people? Do it. Do it. Just do it. It is a brave act. You're respected. You are strong. Don't let a child be an obstacle from you achieving your life, your career, or whatsoever they want to say, man. It's horrible what has been done upon this earth, man. It's really horrible what has been done on this earth. And our people need understanding. You know, it's not only the women, but also these girls that need truly the understanding of what they get themselves involved with, man. Because you got a lot of teenage moms. You know, if you're looking at a program at, I believe it is on MTV, My Sweet 16. Oh no, I believe that is the other one. When they become 16 years old, I don't know, man. Something, you got this program about those 16 year olds being already mothers, parents, you know. But just the whole process, man. Just look at this, man. This is horrible, man. You're just dissecting the child. Just looking at it is just disgusting, and it looks cruel. It looks cruel. It's It's cold, it's wicked, man. It's not what the Most High wants to be executed on this earth, man. But now we're gonna go to Planned Parenthood to give you an understanding of the mind, which kind of people are behind this, and what kind of quotes they have. Let's look at Margaret Sanger. You know, what kind of spirit, what kind of person is she? This is what she says. "We want to exterminate the Negro population," Margaret Sanger. So why do you think that a lot of these brown skin daughters of Israel, who are Hebrew Israelites predominantly, are deceived to commit this crime? You gotta understand what is taking place upon this earth, man. You gotta understand that these are the examples of the devil plotting and gnashing upon the people, upon the Israelites, man. These are the arrows that are being shot at the hidden ones, man, at the Israelites, man. This is another one. "The most merciful thing that a large family does to one of its infant members is to kill it." This is Margaret Sanger, man, founder of Planned Parenthood. Let it sink in, man. Let that sink in. We got another one. "They are human weeds, reckless breeders, spawning human beings who never should have been born." Yo, this bitch is against life, man. She, man, this bitch is truly straight up death, man. She's death, man. You know, this is truly an example of the harbinger of death. You see? And this is the founder of Planned Parenthood, man. You got another one. "Eugenics is the most adequate and thoroughly avenue to the solution of racial, political, and social problems." You see what she's saying, man? You see what she's saying? And you got to understand that they are mainly aiming at our people, man. You better wake up and understand what is going on, man. You gotta understand what is going on, with what kind of sick and twisted force we are battling with, man. You know, we do not want to go out that we want to exterminate. We don't want word to go out that we want to exterminate the Negro population. You see this? Because it's a secret. They want to do this in secret, man. They don't want you to know. They're occupied with murdering you while they're setting a smile in their face. This is how they come, man. Psalms 55. They will tell you all the sweet words. "We love you, we care about you, we want to help you. Abortion is a good step. It takes courage. I'm proud of you. It's a brave step." Psalms 55, verse 21. "The words of his or her mouth were smoother than butter, but woe was in his or her mouth and heart, in her mind. His or her words were softer than oil, yet were they drawn swords." They will tell you all the things about the benefits of committing an abortion. It's your body, you know, while they're just fixated on just exterminating you, taking you down, slaying you. That's the mind of these sickos, man. That's the mind of these sickos. That's why these people are going to pay for what they have done, man. Everybody, this the whole founder of this, she is going to pay. But everybody that is in line and doing these things and thinks it is acceptable, they're going to pay. You know? It's just this total madness, man. This is just total madness, man. You know? And the scripture speaks about this, man. The scripture speaks about this. This is the book of Proverbs. Proverbs 29, verse 10. "The bloodthirsty hate the upright, but the just seek his soul." And that's where they are. They're bloodthirsty, man. They're slayers. They're murderers, man. They murder our people, man. They murder our people day in, day out, man. They don't rest. You know, they don't rest, they just continue, man. Job 24, verse 14. The murderer rising with the light killeth the poor and needy. They murder, they slay the poor and needy in the light. And in the night is as a thief. And when it is night, they steal, they rape, they do all these sneaky, wicked things, man. Continually occupied in mischief, man. That's them. That is the nation of Edom. And they continually target at our people, man. They continually target at our people. So if you sleep and you don't understand what is going on, you're going to fall for their tricks, man. Micah chapter 2 verse 10. Arise and depart. Wake up and leave off from this world, man, of this place, man. Understand what the wicked is doing towards you, man. Towards the daughters, man. Towards the princesses of our nation, man. They are destroying the daughters of Zion, man. You know? But a lot of our daughters of Zion, they are no longer looking upon themselves and seeing and understanding they are princesses, man. They are not conducting themselves as princesses, man. There is no moral excellency inside of them, man. They are degenerates, they are twerking. They are running around and doing whatsoever with who know what. And when they end up in that position, in that situation, Ray Ray is running off, leaving them behind. And that's why they're getting desperate and they decide to do certain things, man. So everything is just completely out of order, man. Everything is just completely destroyed. And again, you gotta ask yourself the question, like, how is it that our people, how is it that that holy people of the Most High is in this state? Completely out of their mind. The whole head is sick. They have joy in destroying and being destitute of any form of wisdom. And when they are in a certain predicament, they think that death is the solution. Just terminating life is the solution for something that they caused by themselves, man. Arise ye and depart, for this is not your rest, because it is polluted. The whole place is polluted. The input is polluting your mind. Your thought is polluted. Your actions are polluted. Your sight, everything is polluted. It shall destroy you, even with a sore destruction. So now people are being destroyed, man. Everything is being destroyed, man. You know, Hosea 4 verse 6, my people are destroyed for lack of knowledge. Our people, the Israelites, lack the knowledge of the Most High. They lack the understanding of what the will is of the Most High. Because thou hast rejected knowledge, I will also reject thee. So they reject the Most High. So that's why they reject the knowledge of the Most High. So the Most High is going to reject them, man. That thou shalt be no priest to me, seeing that thou hast forgotten the law of the Most High. I will also forget thy children. You know, so the Most High is not looking upon them anymore, man. Because they simply don't want to conform themselves. They don't want to convert. They don't want to return unto the Most High. They don't want to obtain the law of the Most High. You know? So the Most High gives them over into the hands of the wicked ruler, man. And the wicked ruler is crushing them. Is messing their mind up. You know? Is causing them to walk upon the road. Is causing them to walk upon the road where they think that it's acceptable to do those things, man. But it's unacceptable to do these things, man. You know? So Revelation 22 verse 12, this is the last scripture. And I behold, I come quickly, and my reward is with me, to give every man according to his work, according as his work shall be. So everybody upon this earth, for what you do, man, understand, you daughters of Zion, y'all gotta stop doing this, man. The Most High is gonna bring judgment upon this earth, man, for all these things, man. Y'all gotta wake up and understand that this is not the way, man. Don't listen to your oppressor and what he tells you and how you think it's brave to do these things, man. Take care of yourself, man. Take care of the one that is growing inside of you. If the man decides to leave, then at least continue, man. Don't terminate the life of the one that is growing inside of you based on if a man wants to leave, man. You know, if you doubt that you are capable of taking care of the child that is growing inside of you, then give your child to someone that is capable of raising your child, man. You know, because there are so many ways of dealing with the situation, man, instead of just destroying, man. You know, instead of just being a promoter of death, man, instead of walking in a way of what this devil wants you to do, man. You see? So hey, this is what I quickly wanted to bring out, man. All praise to Yahweh, Bashim Yoshai. Bashim Rukakadash, Shalom.